the mighty Amazon winds its way through the heart of Brazil, we find many strange and exotic species of flora and fauna. For instance, this odd-shaped basket of... this happens to be the Dasypodidae, or armadillo, sometimes pronounced armadijo, but affectionately nicknamed tattoo. With his ability to dig in at lightning speed, we find him equally at home either below or above the ground. The little armadillo, tattoo to you, is a very timid creature, and at the slightest noise, even the drop of a pin, he snaps into a solid ball, becoming, so to speak, a hard nut to crack. When satisfied that the coast is clear, he unrolls his one-man top and proceeds on his way. Another strange creature often found in this region is the turista americana, or American tourist.
15 minutes stopover in Belém. All passengers, 15 minutes.
Come on, Poodle. Stretch your legs. That's it. Nice going, boy. Go get it, Poodle. Come on.
Thank you. Vicinity, guard that pillbox with your life.
Spring, loveliest time of the year. Oh, let us away to skip and play, for the spirit of spring is here. Awake, awake to its fairy ring. Hark, let's respond to the call of spring. What is more fragrant among all things than the smell of trees in the early spring? Ah, merrily pipes the bluebird, happy troubadour of spring. They frisk and play. Here's to springtime any day.
Spring, spring, spring. Wonderful, wonderful springtime.
Hurry, 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 lest thou be late to thy prearranged fate.
questioning. Spin thy cloak for evolutioning. Hang, hang in suspended animation till comes the call for alteration.
Springtime rain, floating earthward once again. Soft, misty dew from clouds on high, a moistening link twixt earth and sky. To drink thy freshness, never fail. All hail to springtime, hail, hail, hail!
O gentle showers, thou art gone. How sad to see thy end. Spring's happy spirit now pipes his birth. Let us rejoice again. Oh, dance to springtime's joyous calling, and prance amidst sweet dewdrops falling. Leap high in air amidst the breezes. Oh, happy time, joy never ceases.
Would you like to help me? Get some more bandages. Now, don't you two get into any trouble while I'm gone.
Thank you.
better kiss and make up. Go on.
Sharp lookout and let no one aboard. Understand?
Thank you.
Deserted your post, eh? You left the ship unguarded to hijack food. A sea dog, eh? Why, you're nothing but a common wharf rat.
Howdy, folks. Ever see anything beat this canyon country? Yes, sir. Old Mother Nature has sure carved out some mighty pretty scenery. Just look at them rocks over yonder. The Indians tell me some of the daggondest legends about them you ever listened to. For instance, you take this here Coyote Rock over there. Well, sir, it seems as how a long time ago, certain coyote lived in these parts. Old Bent Tail. And a mighty powerful critter he was, with a voice that would turn an opera star green with envy. This here hombre had one weakness. Lamb chop. Fat, juicy, plump lamb chop. His favorite dish. Lamb chops on the hook. But this flock of potential chops was being looked after by man's faithful and trusted friend, the sheepdog. A steady critter who never failed to count his sheep as they bedded down for the night. His sense of responsibility had taught him to be wide awake and ever alert. His keen eyes kept a sharp lookout. Nothing could swerve him from his vigilant watch. But this frisky little rascal, Blackie, wanted to romp around a bit. But the old dog headed him off. You could almost hear him say, "Now look here, son. There's a sheep-eating coyote lurking in them hills. Just wait and wrap his jaws around a little critter like you. Now get back in the corral and stay there." Oh. Well, sir, nearby a certain lamb chops-eating varmint was up to no good. He was a-getting closer and closer. It had a whole passel of tricks for luring a sheepdog away from a corral. Realized what had happened. Old little lamb's left unguarded and a hungry coyote on the loose. He'd better hightail for home before it's too late. But old Bent Tail knew all the shortcuts. He got there first. Trail, but would he get there in time? Once again, the lambs were all safely back in the corral. All but one, Blackie. And was he excited? He'd just seen the fiercest, meanest, biggest coyote you ever laid eyes on. And he's sitting on that rock right over there. The old dog told that little critter, "Shucks, that coyote won't hurt you. He's made of stone." So help me, folks, that's the story behind Coyote Rock. Just as I heard it from the engines.